Welcome to the ProCamera tutorial series. This entire project was filmed using only ProCamera to show you what you can achieve with a little practice. So please join us and learn how to get the very most out of the app. In this tutorial, we walk you through the basics of video mode. We'll show you how to set the resolution and frame rate so that you can achieve stunning video both at regular speed and for cinematic slow motion playback. To access video mode, first tap the camera selector, then tap video. Now we could go ahead and hit the record button, but our shot's not level, so we'll fix that using the TILTMETER. To do this, open the control panel and tap TILTMETER to activate it. You can also combine the TILTMETER with grids for more precision. Simply long press to reveal the grid options, then select the one you want. Adjust your camera until the TILTMETER turns green to let you know the shot's level. Then of course you can open the control panel and hide the tools once you're done using them. ProCamera automatically sets the focus and exposure. But if you want more manual control, please check out our focus and exposure tutorial if you haven't already seen it. Resolution is an essential topic because it refers to the overall image quality of your video. Basically, videos are made up of individual still images called frames. If you pause on one of these frames and zoom in, you're able to see these little bits of information called pixels. And the higher the resolution you record in, the more pixels your camera captures in each frame. This means you'll be able to see more detail in your video, especially when viewed on a full, high-definition screen. It may help to think of pixels like a grid. And with 4K ultra-high definition, each column on that grid contains 2,160 pixels. HD Plus contains 1,080. HD contains 720. And HQ, the lowest resolution, has a pixel height of only 480. HD Plus, which we'll also refer to as 1080, is the standard for professional video and the default setting in ProCamera. Although we recommend filming in a minimum of 1080, you might want to switch to a different resolution depending on your needs. Switch to a new resolution by opening the control panel and tapping Resolution. Swipe to take a look at the different options, then tap to select the one you want. ProCamera is currently the highest resolution option in ProCamera. Take a look at the difference in detail between HD Plus and 4K. Film in 4K to get the best possible image quality. Just be aware that 4K files will take up a lot of space on your iPhone. With faster movement, you may not notice a huge difference between HD Plus and HD. But with slower movement and zoomed in, the HD clip doesn't look as sharp compared to the HD Plus. Because of its very low image quality, we don't recommend filming in HQ. It's there mostly as a courtesy if you're running out of space on your iPhone. Also note that HQ has a 4:3 aspect ratio. This is why you see black bars on either side of the video clip. Thanks to a handy feature in ProCamera, even your largest video files can be exported in smaller, more convenient sizes. And this makes it really easy to share your videos over text message and social media. Once you've selected a video from your camera roll, long press the share button. From there, it's pretty straightforward. Select the size you want, tap next, then choose where you want to share your video. Ever wonder how to get that smooth, slow motion effect in your videos? It all has to do with framerate, or FPS. FPS stands for frames per second. This refers to the number of frames your camera captures per second when recording video. And the more frames your camera is able to capture per second, the smoother the movement will appear when you slow the video down upon playback. The standard frame rate for television and movies is between 24 and 30 frames per second. The default setting in ProCamera is 30 FPS, which is perfect when you want motion to appear natural at regular playback speed, just like you see here. To create the slow motion effect, you'll need to at least double the frame rate you normally film with. Switch to a new frame rate by first opening the control panel, and then tap frame rate. Swipe to check out the frame rate options, then tap the one you prefer. Since we're filming with 30 FPS, we'll choose 60 FPS for our side-by-side slow motion comparison. This is 50% playback speed. By doubling our frame rate, we were able to maintain smooth, natural motion in our 60 FPS clip. This is 25% playback speed. To keep the movement appearing smooth at this speed, we filmed in 120 FPS. And finally, this is 10% playback speed. With 240 FPS, the motion still appears very smooth, even when the video is played back so slowly. But it comes at a cost, because the higher the frame rate you film with, the lower the image quality becomes. Good light is always important for achieving professional video, but this is especially true when filming with very high frame rates. We turned off the main overhead lights to show what happens to the image quality under low light conditions. Notice the image noise in the 240 FPS clip on the right. The quality might look okay on a very small screen, but viewed on a larger monitor, you'll notice the low image quality. Under low light, we found that 60 FPS was a good compromise. We were able to create that smooth, slow motion effect without sacrificing too much image quality. We hope you enjoyed the video and that it helped to demystify the topics of resolution and frame rate. While there's a lot more we could have discussed, these are the basics to help get you started. Keep in mind that the options available and your overall results will vary depending on the generation of iPhone you use. We use the iPhone 7 and 7 Plus. Spend some time practicing, and you'll soon be able to take your video skills to the next level. We'd also like to say a special thank you to choreographer Adrian Hart and dancer Anna Paolo from Neon Dance Company. Please check out the other videos in our tutorial series by clicking the link on the right. If you don't have ProCamera and are interested in getting the app, click the logo to download it from the App Store. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe to our channel for future updates.